This is The Rundown. I'm Hari Sreenivasan, and I am joined by Julie Appleby today to talk health exchanges. Now, we've heard about this. This was one of the cornerstones of the health reform plan passed by the administration. First of all, what are they?
Well, you're right. This is one of the key elements of the reform plan. And basically what it is going to be a marketplace, an online marketplace, where individuals and small businesses can go to buy health insurance.
And where are they going to be? Are this going to be one central site or 50 sites?
There will probably be a number of sites. Each state can set one up if they want to. States don't have to set them up. And if the states either can't or won't set one up, the feds are going to run it. And states can also get together if they wanted to and form a regional exchange. So several states could get together to do that.
And so when I go into this marketplace, is this going to be like comparing, you know, vacation trips from different sites, or comparing other kinds of insurance? Like now you have car insurance sites that
It's a little similar to that. It's kind of like the airline sites where you want to go somewhere. There's some differences, though, with that. When you're buying an airplane ticket, there's a few variables, right? You want to go from point A to point B, and you kind of know the variables are how much do you want to pay, and do you want a nonstop or a red eye? This is similar because you picking health insurance, but it's a little more complicated because, you know, what do you want in deductibles? What do you want in copays? So they're trying to make it a little easier to understand by creating these four broad categories of plans. So it'll be a bronze plan, a gold, a silver plan, a gold, and a platinum plan.
Okay.
And within those, they differ on how generous they are, basically. How much of the healthcare costs, on average, they're going to pay. So a bronze plan would probably pay the least amount towards your coverage. It's going to be the lower amount. The platinum plan will pay the most. And the premiums will sort of reflect that. And the differences then within those categories will be what you'll be choosing on. So it'll be things like, how much do you want to pay in deductible? How much do you want to pay in sort of the co-insurance? How much do you pay every time you go to the doctor? That type of thing.
So within the platinum plan, there might be other choices that you could
make. There'll be other choices. And they're trying to simplify that. It's still going to be complicated, but they're trying to simplify it. It's, in fact, starting next year, all insurers are going to be required to give out 4 to 6 page summaries of their plans that are supposed to help you compare them sort of apples to apples. So they'll list what do they cover, what medical services they cover, what are your deductibles, what are your copays. Then there'll be a few additional pieces in there. Like say, they'll have three items. They'll say you're having a baby. How much would this plan cost you to have a baby? Say you have breast cancer, how much would this plan cost if you had breast cancer? And say you're managing diabetes, how much would this plan? So then you can compare them and see, because there will be differences between the plans.
So, and first of all, who's also eligible in terms of, it's not everybody that's going to walk into these exchanges on day one whenever they open up, right?
Right. No, at first it's individuals, and it's employees of firms with 100 or fewer workers, and in some states it might be 50 or fewer. So initially it's for small businesses and individuals. And they're estimating that in 2014, the first year that they're open, that about 12 million people will buy on the exchanges. And by 2018, about 27, 28 million. And the vast majority of those folks will be eligible for subsidies. They'll be coming in for subsidies
through
Medicaid or through subsidies. So that's the other big element of exchanges that we haven't spoken about. Is it's also a way to determine who's eligible for Medicaid. And they've expanded Medicaid, which is the state federal program for low-income folks. They've expanded it to more people. So these exchanges are also going to play a role in helping enroll people in that program.
Okay, so you've been covering this topic for a while. What's the kind of rosy scenario that the government would like us to get to, in the sense that if everything works great, what is the hopeful outcome?
What they're hoping is that this will be a very smooth transition, that folks will be able to enroll in Medicaid, they'll find out if they're eligible for it, or they'll be able to buy insurance, that a number of insurers will participate. In fact, it might increase competition, which might drive down costs. So that's the rosy scenario. They're really hoping that this will provide more competition, more choice for folks, and slow the growth of premiums.
Okay.
The concern is that if the way these are set up, it may or may not work that way. There could be situations where it might be less expensive for folks to buy outside the exchange, for example. And if that happens, the younger, healthier people might all decide to buy outside the exchange, which would leave the older or sicker people inside the exchange, and that could raise premiums further and further. So there could be these problems, and this is what states and others are having to wrestle with right now on how they design their exchanges, how they design the rules for insurers that are selling in the exchange and outside the exchange and that type of thing. So those kinds of details are still being worked out, but that's some of the concern.
So this is still in the preliminary stages, but where can people go to find more information?
You can go on hhs.gov. They have some website information. You could go on Kaiser Health News, which is what I work for, has a lot of information. We've done some stories on exchanges. That's another place to go.
All right, Julie Appleby from Kaiser Health News. Thanks so much for joining us.
Thank you.
This is The Rundown. I'm Hari Sreenivasan. Stay with us.